So, this is a story all about how my life got flipped turned upside down. Kinda. So what happened was, I was gonna film a completely different video titled A Review on Huion Drawing Tablet 1 Year Later. Here's the tablet. It's a small pen tablet. It's a Huion H640P. I loved it dearly while it lasted, but it didn't last long. 2 days before I was gonna film the video, it just completely gave out on me. Mid-painting, it just stopped working. Mind you, that would mean that I also only had 2 days left on my warranty, and whenever I plug it in, it would have this little bloop 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 connect sound, and then bloop bloop bloop, the little disconnect sound playing like a second later. Even though the driver would say the device is connected, and the pen would not just respond. So I started troubleshooting, you know. Getting different drivers, updating my Windows, getting different cable, trying it on a different computer, reinstalling all the drivers, nothing worked. So I emailed Huion customer service on April 30th and I was like, hey guys, my tablet just stopped working, can we do something about it? I got an automated response saying, we got your email, but we're not gonna be in the office until May 4th because of the first of May is the national holiday. I was like, fuck. So I mailed them back and I said, my warranty is expiring before you guys, I'm coming back in the office. Can we do something about it? So they got back to me. They started troubleshooting. We started troubleshooting again. They had me record everything on the video and send it to them. Then they sent me some kind of diagnostic software to try, and I opened it. I tried to move the pen around. It didn't work. I sent the video back to them and they said that it appears to us that your pen is broken. So we could send you a new pen, but you have to pay for shipping. I was like, god damn it. It's on warranty, but they tried to get you pay for shipping and stuff. But whatever. The thing that also upset me is that I was recommending it to people left and right, and not even a couple hours before it broke, I was talking to somebody on comment section on YouTube, and I was like, yeah, I have this, and it's been working great, and I love it. And a couple hours later, just died. However, my boyfriend secretly went ahead and bought me a brand new tablet, a beautiful gift. He bought me it, he surprised me with it, he gifted it to me, and he said, I just want you to be happy, so I want you to have it. I know how much it means to you, so please have it. I'm like, okay, thank you. I'm forever grateful, I love it, and it's a very nice gift. So I've decided to film a little review thing on it, just share my thoughts on it. The tablet that he got me is this big boy. It's a XP Pen Deco 3. Some people would say, why would you go with another Chinese brand when your previous Chinese brand tablet gave out on you? But it was a gift. I have nothing to complain about. I've been using it for a few days now, and I figured I'd share some thought about it. Side note, the footage that's going to be playing on the screen alongside with the review is the painting that I did on this new tablet. So this tablet costs $100. The tablet itself is quite a bit larger. The active area is 10 by 5.6 inches with 8,192 levels of pressure sensitivity. It supports 6 express keys and a red wheel, which they call the red dial, that you can program to perform certain commands like zoom in and zoom out and changing the brush size, rotating the canvas, and so on. You can assign one of the buttons to cycle through up to 4 wheel functions, but I found it not very comfortable and kind of pain in the ass because I keep forgetting what function the wheel is set to at the moment, and I end up doing things that don't need it to be, which slows down my painting process. So I assigned the wheel to being only zoom in and zoom out on the canvas, which is primarily what I wanted it to be, so it's not a big deal. The buttons are somewhat cheap feeling, but it's not a big deal as long as it don't break. The wheel setup was kind of pain in the ass because there are no instructions neither in manual or on XP Pen website how to do this. It took a little bit of time, I figured it out. You can set the tablet into left-handed mode, so you can flip it, and then the buttons and the wheel are on the right side and the bottom, and I kind of like them better in that position, but I'm right-handed, so I can't use it that way. The tablet has wireless function, and you can plug it in with the provided USB-C type cable to use it as just regular wired tablet. Wireless works better than I expected. I expected a lot more lag, but I didn't encounter too much of a lag. It can lag a little on very quick strokes, but I generally work pretty slow, so the lag hasn't really been affecting me, and I've been using it primarily wireless. The range seems pretty good, as long as nothing obstructs the tablet from the receiver that is plugged into a computer. The battery life is pretty good. I haven't had to charge it yet. I've been using it for a few hours every day for about 4 days now, and there's still charge left in there, so no complaints there. The only time I plugged it in is when I was trying out a wired connection versus wireless. I'll pop a picture on the screen of the jitter test, and there's a good bit of jitter when you go really slow with the ruler on the tablet and you go really slow diagonally. There's a good bit of jitter there, so that's something to be considered, but I can work around it. The tablet surface has some tooth to it. It's not completely smooth, like plastic smooth, so your pen doesn't just slide around. However, because of this tooth on the surface, the pen nibs get ground down really quick. The nib that was in the pen when I received it went flat from this few days of use. But it comes with 8 spare nibs, so I guess you could change them if that bothers you. It doesn't bother me as much, because I don't really care if my pen nib is completely flat or it's brand new. The thing, the nibs don't fit in the little hole that's supposed to remove them, and I don't understand why. The pen is passive, so it's battery free, so it's pretty nice. It's pretty comfortable, it sits on your hand really nicely. It has 2 programmable buttons on the side, with no eraser on the back. Overall, I think it's a decent piece of hardware. The novelty of having this little dial and it being wireless is kinda nice. Aesthetically, it's very pleasing. It's a very pretty device, and I've been very satisfied with it so far. However, obviously, I don't know about the longevity of this device. I don't know how long it's gonna work. Like, I don't know. It might give out on me a year later. Who knows? Overall, if I had to rate it 1 to 5, I'd go with a 4 because of the jitter. Also, the package came with a weird set of gloves. I guess it's kind of like a freebie from the Amazon seller that my boyfriend got it from. It's these nylon gloves with a little bit of like rubbery kind of dots on them. They look kind of like archival. I feel like I would wear them in the museum if I was to work with the really old books. But yeah, overall I think it's a decent device. So I do like this device a lot. It's very beautiful. It's definitely a step up from my previous tablet. Even in just Activary alone is quite larger, which I like. Would I recommend it to somebody else? Yes, but I would probably consider that it's very possibly not a device that's gonna last your lifetime. I feel like it's a step in between having a very cheap entry-level basic little tiny drawing tablet and having a higher end device. I feel like it's a nice between, it's a nice medium. There is room to grow from it, but it's also not just bare bones. Well, anyway, thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, please give me a like and subscribe, and check out my social media in the description, and I'll see you next Wednesday. Bye.